so that you and your children may live. Produce. I'm now giving you the choices between life and death. This is what I was looking for. Between God's blessings and God's curses. And I call heaven and earth to witness the choice you make. Choose life. I love that one, that translation. Now, the whole of this week we have been dealing, especially in our lunch hour services, concerning where and how to make choices. What does it mean? Where and how to make choices of life. One of the things that I met today, is it today? Sometimes I've read in a magazine, there's a sister to the former singer Michael Jackson called Janet Jackson. Just giving an example, which is real. Janet Jackson got married to one of the billionaires in Saudi Arabia. In Doha, they say in Doha, a billionaire, one of the big billionaires. But when the guy got married to that lady, the condition number one, he told her, you must choose between Christianity and Muslim. Now the woman sold the money, of course, affluent, the riches, and the grammar. She chose Muslim instead of Christianity. She was raised up as a Christian woman from the family where she came from. But she chose to be a Muslim, that lady. Now, after that choice was made by that lady, she was taken from America, taken to Doha in somewhere, Saudi Arabia. And this lady, the choices she made concerning her marriage life, as Chase trusted, she says she wanted to commit suicide last week. Now she has left that marriage, she has left the billions, she has left that, and she's now living out of the Muslim. But now, you know, you think it's easier to live the religion. The religion, is, my friend, is a covenant that you enter. Even that's why, even when you find the backsliders, those who have sinned against God, those who have forgotten their father, children everywhere, they have given birth to children, all recognized inside and straight, but still they insist they are Christians. Am I right? They insist they are what? Some even they don't want to leave churches. Even when the pastor stands and excommunicate them, they say, no, I'm not leaving. Some even they sue pastors and say, I must remain a Christian all the days of my life. So this woman made a choice to be a wife to that billionaire. And from there, so she discovered when she joined that denomination, the religion of Muslim. So, you know, you understand what happens in the religion of Muslim. The movement is limited. You are not allowed. Everything is provided. She was saying she is not allowed to drive a car. Yeah, because he's a billionaire. He can, he has all the employees, he has all the security guards. That every time she goes into the supermarket, bouncers are there. Every time she goes anywhere in a salon, the security men are surrounding there. So every time that this woman wants to operate in a freedom area, in an environment of freedom, she's under surveillance. So what happened? This woman has said she found it hard. She wanted to commit suicide. And then she got a counselor outside to make a choice over your life concerning marriage. She said, for honestly, the first choice I made was not even a man. I made out of the finances, out of the fame of the money that I have seen. And that is what is happening virtually into marriages that are in trouble today. They are women, they are men today who have made choices about their marriages. They have made choices about their friends. There are people, I was told another brother was shot in Kisumu with his friend. They were together. They were big businessmen. But they were working with a friend. And in the process of working with a friend, saying that people want to assassinate this guy. So they worked together, somewhere in Mamboreo, I don't know, and this guy was shot together with his friend, they were killed. But the friend who was killed, he is not aware of any crime he has committed. But he had chosen a friend. So when you choose a friend, also you must be ready for the consequences of friendship. I say you must be ready for the consequences of the friendship. That's why choices that you make in life determines the life that you live. Praise the Lord. And where you make your choice, there are people who make choices out of emotions. Emotions. One of the many political people in this country, Fred Kabudo. And you don't know why the guy died without being elected again. Even after he left, he said he has sworn to himself, even if he's cut today, the blood that will flow belongs to Kanu. And the guy left Kanu. He had made a choice. Verbally, he was speaking, but spiritually, it was being organized that permanently the man will remain Kanu. Praise the Lord. So when you make a choice, number one, you must be very careful where you are making the choice, why you are making the choice, who you are making a choice with, and how will the choice affect your own life. Because don't say you are a Christian by choice, by birth. Don't say I am. There are people today who are saying they are Christians by name, by name. They said the Bible, they are Christians. They are Christians. But if you look at the choices they have made, they only want to be a Christian because they want to be buried well. That brother told me the other day, I want to be buried by this religion. And I told him, you don't believe in rapture? He said, no. Me, I will be buried. This is the church that will bury me. So a choice that you make, where you make your choice. You make what? When you make your choice. After Moses spoke to children of Israel at that particular place. Let's go down. This is what they say. Let's go to the next verse. Moses. And what? He told them, you choose today. One. Love what?
Love the Lord.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Listen to this. That's what he said. After you make that choice, number one, you shall live long. You shall do what? That's why even today in the secular world they are advertising, oh, if you are HIV positive, you can make a choice to live what? You can live long. By making your choices. I'm making you abstain. I don't know, you eat well, you exercise well, you do what? You can still live. They know what's bad. This one, it was spoken. The fact choice say, love the Lord your God. Obey him. The third one, be faithful. What is the word? Love the Lord. Obey him. And also be faithful. Those are very hard choices. People think they are easy choices. To love Jackson is not easy. You can give without loving, but you cannot love without giving. I repeat my statement again. The level of love that you have toward God, number one, it depends on how you give from your time, from your commitment, from anything that you are doing for God, how you do it. Because you cannot love without giving. Amen? But you can give without love. You can, people give prostitute money on the street. People donate in some fundraisers where they are not even supposed to. People give, I mean they give everywhere. But that one is not love. It's not what? Not love. He said, one, love the Lord your God. That's it. Love for God, my friend, is so strong. Then he said that the passion and the affection of God, the affection of the house of God is in my heart. I, David, my child, the seal in the house of God. Psalm 69:9, the Bible says, the seal of God has consumed me. Love. A man, was it not? Look at the man who has loved a woman, my friend. A guy, I don't know Number one, you devote yourself. You do what? The first question, David looked at a lot of Saul. He looked at it and he said, this girl is very beautiful. And he said, what is the price that for one to have this one as his wife? The Bible says, if you read the Bible very well, the Bible says, and the Saul said, that because David has loved my daughter, and I'll make this girl become a snare. Become what? A snare. How did he become a snare? The Bible says, and the short thing, anybody that want to, because they all and ask a price tag. What's the devil? The man said, no. That one is not even required. What is required is 100 Philistine foreskins of men. You get every Philistine from everywhere, you cut them, they are sexual baggers, you cut them, put on the tray, take it the king. How? Ruthless. Because you know, you as a new one, the second one, the third one, you are king. Can you not? Is it possible? I said, is it possible to do that? Is it possible? Even when you are targeting even a woman, when she wants to kill a man, you go straight to his sexual worker, you touch it, you squeeze it, the man will give it, he'll say, I surrender all. The Bible says, and when David laughed, the building, I said, I love it. Hello? That love itself brought the man. The Bible says, he called his friends. He called what? Because he knew these are heavy tasks. These are strong tasks. These are very strong tasks. Let me call my friend. But the father to Micah, the wife, the father knew that I have sent his name. I have said what? Nimeweka mutego, na huyo mutego, akiruka hii, kuja manda mwoko. Niletee 100 foreskins of the Philistine. Who are you talking about? The Philistine, why the children of Israel were running away from? Nobody could stand with them. Nobody could talk to them. Nobody even dared talk to those guys. They were running away from them. So this man said, give me the fire. The Bible says, David took his man, but the courage was from above. From what? When you love Jackson, when you love, if you love the house of, if you love God, my brother, we can't push you every day. Hello? They have to call up and say, hello, the pastor, say, you know, Nakata, say, you know, squeezing, hello. And I got a message. Just I wanted to know whether you are coming. So, hello. Those man says we have stopped it forever. I think God gives us another grace. Oh, Korean man. And see Sunday. Unless you know somebody is sick. Is what? To be told to the Mugonjua, not to December, we will come Mugonjua. Give us a message, your papa. Kindly, I'm not well. Everybody is here. Everybody is here. Everybody is here. All of them. Give us a few texts and say, I am not feeling. You can't be grown up Jackson and you keep on growing every day. You are a grown up and you know you are in a position of this ministry. And then we keep on following you every day. Because you have no love of God. We can't continue looking for you every day. And when people speak like this, they say you are proud. Excuse me, please keep people break. People grow. Kule mtu anakuja kelele hapa saa hii, kuna siku atafika. Kwanza hiyo, kula, unamfuata, daddy, kula kidogo. Next time you don't even ask him alikula. The next thing ni kutoa ile kitu kwa meza. You don't remember whether he touched or he. Saa ya kukula imeisha, kila mtu alale tunaona asubuhi. Oh, siku nimekula nilikuwa nini? When time of eating, everyone must be on the table, must be what? Ama inaendaga ali? Tizaji yungu na kituja? Tadikula! Anaweka kwa mnama kato. Buzi au mwashika wana tukua kwa kuya. Oh no. Wani wana wakia 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 jari wakia wakia wakia. Look at something, sir. Kuna wakia 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 mtu na wangela ya mtu na wakia. Njue kani nimi mwini ya mtu na mtu kuna mtu ya mtu kwa tata. You know, what about that about the Jackson? Then you cheat, it's not the outlet.
Rachel. What did he do?
He was told to work for how many years? I said, how many years? The man worked 7 years like a day. After he was done, he went again. The Bible says he was deceived. He was given now. And the guy changed his mind immediately and said, no. He said, please give me what I love. What I did not? And he was said, now again, that is the condition. Because if you work for the firstborn for 7 years, work again. The Bible says, Jacob worked for a woman only for 14 years. How many years?
14.
For 20 years, the guy was in 11th place. The guy worked for women for 14 years. That's what, since you started working. How many years have you been working? Since you came from school? Can you see? So, for the last 14 years, we would have been here in Shah. Yan, umeraka pay in a judge, in a standing order, in a dogger. Your money, you don't even eat even a couple. Not even a, you don't even buy even a shoe. Say you go on a tembe and a car. On a picture like you go on a movie, hey sister. Mwaza angalia biya tu miwa. We mwana 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 sister, I am saving for our wedding. Am I in heaven? I am saving for what? Nilikuwa na kaka atao hivi napitia kwa leo kaka anamwambia eh sister leo nimepata dawa. Harusi, harusi ipo amani. Namwambia tuliende kwa watu wa harusi kwa nguo. Wale wanafanya wanashona nguo ya harusi. Sina hela. Nikaenda. Hala pole hivyo. Nikaenda nikaingia kwa anambia jipime nguo hapo. Namwambia jipime at what we are. We are not going to beg anybody to give us his wedding. Na mwenye naongea, Edward anaende. Nambia mtu, ukiamua kufanya kitu na Mungu forever, obviously you never fail. Ngambia mbia pima, kamuliza, pesa ngapi, sijui ngapi, kumi na ngapi, sijui. Ambia pima, andika jina yangu, write my name, not the woman's name, write my name. Kila sana mwambia, nguo nimelipa 500. where you are not faithful on the little. On what?
On the little. The guy who bought Hill Crest schools now. It's a billionaire, it's a millionaire. But the other day, he gives 100% time. Kumbe Hill Crest is now becoming very expensive. Unafanya booking ya mtoto kwa shule, ya hiyo shule sahi, mtoto apiwa kwa tumbe yu, hakuna nafasi. Na sio shule ya ripa 26 mo. Hill Crest, you know it? Is island school in Karen and many other areas in Leo. The most expensive, the proprietor, the owner. It's called Mosavanjos or something. Mosavanjos. Is very committed. Very committed. The guy gives 100% time. What about 26 people? Could you have tried to ask you? Will you know what you're doing? He was teaching me about faithfulness, and it is true. You cannot tell people about faithfulness. Jackson, I tithe. This is a standard, and they don't give money. They don't give to church. Nobody gives, and they give for fame. Catholics give for fame. That's why in project they are very powerful. Okay, when you have a fundraise, the same member of the same church can give $1 million, the same member can give $2 for an offer. They laugh. Yani publicly, ukisimama huko sema, sasa tunataka kutoa kwa ajili ya nini? That they feel good, they feel, because they are out for fame of this one. But when you are faithful, you give faithfully. Give even when everybody is not giving. You don't give because everybody is giving. You give because you are faithful. Amen? Amen. And the Bible, Proverbs 20, the Bible says, a faithful man shall abound in blessings, but he who is haste to be rich shall not go unpunished. A faithful man. This one is honest. The word of Solomon one day. Honest people will live a full, happy life. They will what? Honest what? I say honest what? But if you are in hurry to do what? Una collect that vitu za Mungu, you collect them. Yani, let me tell you, if you are forced to give your time, kama unasukumwa kutoa fungu lako la kumi, if you are forced by any man or any preacher, you are not a Christian at all. You have never even had to get confessed kama unajua Yesu. Honest people will live a full, happy life. But if you are in hurry, you know what? What you are supposed to give to God, you keep it for yourself. You keep it for yourself. I was talking to my brother Jackson sometimes back here. I told him that if I was to transform everything that I get, instead of doing for this church, like this morning, this guy's well, she knew it. Now, when I'm going to speak to the media, I'm going to go see. So, I'm going to forget the investor in Jumia. I'm going to message that I'm going to put it. I need to have a good idea. Nobody has started messages. Was in here. When I'm messages, you keep some more messages. No, you go through them. Kwanza unaziweka zote za kwamba hapo ukiona mahali imelipa mpesa ni unaenda fasi nyingine utashukuru wewe mwenyewe kaka yako. Hata wao wanajifanyana wasobagi messages siku hizi. All of them bury all their messages. Huh? So ndio maana asubuhi kama hizo chakatwa. Kasema hapo mtu amelikuachwa asubuhi tu amejionea huruma. Niongeza zadaka. Ha. Kenya panda ikikapa. Alan Lawrence, your paid due 09, Tarekisa. And they are paid
He's a man. When was that letter? You got it? Friday last week. No, it was Sunday. Now, listen to this. I want you to write down of the people who wrong choices very quickly. How you make choices. Tell your neighbor, making choices. Please tell your neighbor, making choices. Talk to anybody who doesn't care. Tell him, making choices. I want you to write down about the people are documented down in the Bible over 17 type of people who make wrong choices and it is affecting generation to date. You can choose today not to give your tithe, but let me tell you the truth, if you come back to your house, it start eating you one by one. It will start eating your children, start eating you, you become, yet whether you don't become sick, but the more you think you are gathering, the more that money disappears. Now, the first choice in the Bible was Eve. In the book of Genesis chapter number 3, verse number 6, the Bible says she was given a choice by the devil. But already God had made a choice. She was given a choice. And said, if you eat this tree, this kind of a fruit, if you eat it, you are going to have knowledge. The devil comes and tells you that if you give the tithe, you are going to be poor. I have given you this testimony before, and this has been all over again. One day, I didn't give up my tithe. Can we say it's a true story? That time I was not married. So I used to stay alone. You know what happened when I met Choma Kanyama? There's a couple which was there. Choma Kanyama, what happened? Then we work out garden. So things are very easy. So soon I got a room, you know, gray, no, brownish. Very nice one. Did you put a wrong week at fry, son? Then I took a tithe. I didn't throw it over and do the shit. I took and I bought the Kachkoi Rogi, the Kavar, Missouri, the Kapiga Passing, the Kataki, Missouri, the Katabia town. I have taken. Now you will not any more robo. It happened two tragedies in my life at that time. The Kachkoi, your person, the Kanua, trouser, the Kapiga, your trouser, the Kanua, the Kavar, the Kavar, the Natabia, Palepo Mosquito, the Chile Jamia, Natabia Mosquito, my friend, who to America, the Galilean, and now I'm a kid. Nikapita hivi ndugu yangu. Hiyo roli nilinunua na tight kubwa. Iliraruka kutoka hapa. Paka huko ikainua kagitambara kote ni mwa. Sasa unaonekana nilikuwa nimetaki. Mzee mmoja ndiye alinihurumia akaniambia bongo. Yo, pole. Sasa kitu unaweza fanya? Just untuck the shirt. Wewe tu toa shirt ndani, mfungue hivi. Ikaribu mudi yangu. Ilipari kumuni yangu nikaikuwa kaya hiyo tupeza ikuwa mabaki nikaanza kumuwa nyama nikuwa nuwa nyama na 56 nikuwa nimeanza kumuwa nyama 25 nikuwa nimeongeza bali nikuwa 20 nikachukua nikaanza kanyama katika hiyo stress nikakawekelea kwa stofu ya vitambi nichemuke tu nikule ugali nifikirie vile longi yangu itaikaba nilipokuwa nimeekelea hapo nikakaa kwa kiti nilipokaa kwa kiti nikaanza kufikiria vile nikaanza mawazo tu vile hiyo roho yangu imeenda. Usingizi ikanichukua. Kale kanyama kako pale kwa nini? Kale kako kwa stove. Nimeweka na maji kalikuwa yamechemka hivi. Nakwambia brother, nilikuwa nimeenda kuzingia saa 1:30. Kuamka ni saa 3:30, nikapata nyumba mzima imejaa moshi. Ile nyama kamerudi kutokota, kamerudi kuchoma kenyewe. Nikapata moto kabisa, kamenja. Hata siwezi nikaosha hata mara. That day, my brother, I was worked up. I don't know who I was. Kama ningekuwa nimeoa that time, labda ningepiga kwa hiyo. I got so annoyed. Yani, nikarudi. My trousers imeharibika. That day, ni kule kanyama nisikia at least hii asira imepungua, ikaongeza tena. Nilienda nikaangalia hiyo sufuria hivi,
That's not the anointed. Lakini ukizoa hiyo inaenda sema tatpe. The last if you meet her. If you open this my sister, you meet ever your grandmother have a bit of precarious. Especially when you are pregnant, now you're going to labor one. Utoke huko juu kazi nzima ama kabla hujaenda umpeleke au talk to her. She was given a choice before God. I said, don't touch this one, but she took a choice and touched it, and from there a curse came to man. From that day, the Bible says that a woman shall keep back by pain, and forever the desire of a woman shall be in a man. That's why everyone should marry. It is incomplete. No matter how rich she is, no matter how much you have, there's a vacuum. No matter how powerful you can be, a woman is a billionaire. At some level, there's a vacuum. There's what? There's a vacuum. So, dinner and choice. Let's go first to Genesis chapter 36. She made a choice. That's the first one. Who made the wrong choice? We are not in line today. Don't worry. I want to teach you these things so that it can enter your stomach. She made a choice and also passed on with the what? I don't even imagine Jackson. He sweat yote umetoka narko jana usiku, umefika hapa saa mbili usiku, umetoka huko leo unamaliza ibada, utoke hapa ungangane, kaka, 3-4 hours, all the night unashuka. Then saa kumi na mbili, you are woke, saa kuna wani, umeoka, munu, kunye, kachai, pururu, usimame kwa mlango ya Barclays, una sweat. Do you know what? At least you brother get you up. Eat. Nikoi. They are brothers here. Get you. No, in a year trainer. Yeah, Bunia Zunia B. Jamal, we do not know what I'm with. What way do you know to understand in Bunia? What am I about? Yes, I saw that one, but it's a way of a man to charge my. The moon up on the Maria Kwamawe. You know, kitu kata kwa mwe honi kawisa. Mungu wa Israel, if you have a way to deliver mtu kama kwa Marita from this, Mungu si umletea na basi spot pesa, akwachwe 20 billion, aondoke ipi to beyele. Ununa mtu anasuati hivyo, anachukua hiyo pesa, amebeba kwa shida, ametua, mwanamume tua. Yana, a man, because the Bible says, a man, his ground is cast for his shakir, backsweat. The ground is cast for his sake. For what? Because of the choice of a woman. A choice of what? Let's paraphrase first. What does the Bible say? Then the eyes of both were what? Please read loudly. They were what? And they were what? And they knew. They were what? Initial demo, akukuweko na nguo za kuvaa. Munatembea na bibi. Kama bibi ni one wife, one man, muko free, munatembea. Kila mtu you are connected. Kwani ng'ombe na mbuzi zinavaa nguo? Sema ukweli wa Jehova. Hai. Na wale zinavaa nguo? I was in the game park in Voi, Savo East. Tukaambiwa simba huwa inakuwa na familia. Inakuja, inakuwa na mke mmoja wake. Sasa ikikuja simba, ikikuta huyu mwanamke alikuwa na watoto, hiyo simba huwa kitu inafanya, inaua, ina fight, inaua wale watoto wote, inaanza na one family. And you don't see them, you see animal last in each other. Umeiona ng'ombe na mbuzi, zinatembea filifili. Umeiona zikitamaniana. Hebu wanawake wako hapa town wanabanga hivi. Wako wanafanya mazoezi ya kutafuta wanaume wa watu. Kuna mungu amebaa. Mimi sikatiko hapa ndio natembea hivi. Juzi kwa natembea jana juzi tulikuwa hapa kwa mafuta daga Petrosen kwa ndugu yangu hapo. Mwanamke mmoja hapa hapa amesimama hivi amebaa white. White kangu white kamefika kako hapa. Tena je kama sasa anapulishwa kanafanya hivi. Anapulishwa. Everybody here, everybody, and you know what? I don't know how God created man. Because Genesis chapter number 1, verse number 1, verse number 1, and when God saw, and also when the man saw, a woman, he said, this is the bone of? And the flesh of what? Yes. A man was created by God to see. So when a man sees, his network goes off. Goes what? Every man, if a woman finds a man naked on the street, he feels bad. He says, what is this devil doing in the street? A woman gets annoyed. Is it true? There's no woman who can see a naked man gets it. But if a woman sits back, oh man, until you are delivered, you can put your eye there, but your soul is there. And Moses and they saw what the eyes were open and they knew they were what? And they were naked. But the Bible says in the Bible, and they were naked, but they were not ashamed of each other before. Every animal under the face of the earth, none of the animals put on clothes, but they are living with discipline. With what? So when nobody wants Adam, Mombe, Adam, unona iwa bestia kina wakina Jacksoni ya injodi the famous Mara migration. While this migration, sinapohama Tanzania, dunia kuchukua mimba sinaenda nayo. Sinachukua mimba, sinatokala, sinamufu kuja huku, sinachukua mimba hapa. When they are time, hata ngombe yonolawa inatakala mbe, watsiso nyake ikifika, huwa sasa ni inaendala. Na ndume hili ambayo inajua, hii ndio sisoni ya hii ngombe ya kupata mbe, unaonaka. Si ovyo ovyo kufanya, unaona ngombe zimanya mapesi, reckless like me. Nauliza tu wapendo, have you seen, sahi tuende hizi loti nikikuwa pata msifunguliwe mi, waa! Ndio tabia utapiga we yani hata even chama mchuni usiku kwa magari kwa nuduka kwa nini kwa street kwa vichaka wengine kwa maini every available place but I'm missing and was doing that kind of things. Do you see that? Even where that queen you mna mangombe nyingi zinatembea ovyo ovyo mbuzi na kondoo. Do you find them mating anytime everywhere? When the season is here, the other one knows. You know? In Achua, where the money don't have to come on, but they 1 hour and I find out where my grandmother and who's in the condo. After who was in a quad attracted, you are cutting in a tack and bebu. He didn't give it after you are captain in a nusa to in a quagana network. There's a man who won't be money in a taji who supplier. Na ikimaliza inakwenda lake kaptemba and that is all. Is it true? Yes. Wanaume wako wanaweka mwanamke amewekwa kaptemba mwingine amewekwa nini? Yaani wapo kila mahali wamesupplyo. Wamesupply na watu wale wengine. Mpaka mmoja ameandika juzi asubuhi kwa jana. Kwa naangalia kwa Facebook anasema mimi sina problem kuishi na bwanangu akamwambia akiamua kuoa. Mimi sina problem kuishi na the second wife. Sina shida. Bora tu moja aishi jirimu moche na mwingine akae na ngata prison. Anasema that's how they will live peacefully. The only way they can live peacefully is one in moche, another one in ngata prison. Know that they are alive, all of them together. He has no problem. So the Bible says, they opened their eyes and they found they were what? I said they were what? Please talk to me. They were what?
Naked.
They were naked. So that first choice was very good. The second choice was Abraham. This is what I want to finish here. Abraham. Genesis chapter 12, verse number 10 and 13. That's how Abraham made a choice going down to Egypt. But initially, God had given instructions. And he still made a choice. That come out of your father's house. Praise the Lord. The decision of making a choice of coming out of your father's house is not easy. See what I see? It must take your courage. Take what?
Courage.
I said, take what? He says, come out of your father's house
Yet God had told him, Abraham, don't go down to what? Go down to Egypt. You make a choice that the consequences thereof, they are going.